Chris with Hydra Unlimited, two bucket system assembly. Let's get into it. Here's your QR code, scan it, get the instructions, get the video that you're watching now. This one's a pain. First up, we got our lids. We'll get these situated. Got our legs. Pump. Circulators with additional tubing. Our components we'll need later. Last circulator and some tubing and our net pots. All right, first up, let's get some Teflon tape on this. Struggle bus. This can be a little bit messy, just as long as you're getting it on and getting a good tight seal when you put your fittings on. Circulator cap. Make sure this is tight. If it leaks, rewrap it, do it better. Looks like we already have one that I wrapped, so we're just gonna go with it. And you know, you can use a plier or a pair of pliers for this application. Makes it really easy. Otherwise, if you feel comfortable using your hands, go for it. This part is finished, so we're gonna move on to the next part, which is, well, let's take a look. May run into this. So, let's prep our spring clamps on the hose. Now, something to mention, you can cut this portion, because all you're gonna go to is a T. So in this instance, we're not gonna cut it, but let's just make sure we get a firm seal. So it's firm. Then we're gonna go to the T. Just make sure you're firm on there. If you cut it, you know, you can drop it down to here. The extra hosing is at your leisure. Now we're going to connect up our circulators. Give it a tug. Make sure these are nice and firm when you pull and they're not coming off, because you're going to have water everywhere later. So these are good. So now we're going to set this off to the side for now. And now it's time to focus on the bucket. So you have this seal. see how it's shiny, smooth, and then your through hole is gonna also be smooth. Let's match those up. This will give you a good seal. And then we're gonna do each bucket. Like to push it through first, get my nut on there, spin it on, and then I might have to readjust it so it's centered, and go ahead and tighten it down. Now you can use pliers for this, not necessarily needed if you feel comfortable, but as long as you don't have leaks, that's good. Tamp these down so it's nice and even. Now, water will also help this. Where I mentioned you can cut this. Now you can cut this down to your preferred length. Personally, I'm just leaving it like this for now, just so you get an idea of how easy it is to assemble. Now, just an FYI, when you get this filled up with water, you can always dose your nutrients through these viewports. And also we have this recess right here, so you can run any sort of sensor through there, so you can monitor that. And that's how it's done. Easy.